Welcome back everyone. This video is for the students of class 7th, subject English, lesson number 3, Gopal and the Hills of Fish. And this lesson is taken from your Honeycomb book. So, as in my previous lecture, I already told you that this chapter will be completed in 2 lectures. So, this is my second lecture. So, the summary of the chapter is, it was the season for Hills of Fish. The fisherman caught a lot of them. They sold them in the market. The prices, they said, were down. This news was discussed by all householders. They were amazed that the fish came to such a low price. In the palace also, the courtiers discussed the matter. A courtier showed the king a big fish he had caught. The king lost his temper. The courtier became silent and said the king realized his mistake. He told that even Gopal could not stop anyone from talking about Hilsa. Gopal protested. He said he could do that. Now when the king made announcement that everybody is busy in talking about Hilsa fish and not even Gopal could not stop anyone even for 5 minutes from talking about Hilsa fish. Then Gopal protested and he said that no majesty, I can do that. The king then challenged him to bring a big fish to the palace without anyone asking a word about it. Since Gopal accepted the challenge, he started working accordingly. He became half shaven and covered himself with ash. When his wife asked him the reason about his peculiar look, a different look, he said that he was dressing up to buy a Hilsa fish. His wife thought he had gone mad. Gopal bought the Hilsa and started walking towards the palace. A child cried that the man was comical. Another called him a madman. The third mistook him for a mystic. Mystic means strange. But no one talked about the fish. So, according to the challenge given by the king, Gopal was ordered to bring a huge Hilsa fish to the palace, but on a condition that nobody should talk about the Hilsa fish even a word. Then, Gopal reached the court. He told the guards that he wanted to see the king. But they did not allow him to enter because they did not recognize Gopal. Gopal began dancing and crying loudly. They reported the matter to the king. The king ordered to bring him to the court. Gopal introduced himself before the king. The king asked him why he was dressed up in that fashion. Gopal explained that when he was coming to the palace, not a single man spoke about the Hilsa fish. Everyone got attracted towards his peculiar look. They did not mind the fish. The king remembered the challenge he had thrown to Gopal. He congratulated Gopal on his achieving the impossible. Now, we shall do our new words and question answers in our fair notebook. So, first of all, take out your fair notebooks. Make a proper format, draw margin, write down date, day, lesson number 3, Gopal and the Hilsa fish. And after that, write down this heading, new words. So the first word is fishmongers. Its meaning is dealers of fish. I repeat, the first word is fishmongers. Its meaning is dealers of fish. Second word is majesty. Majesty means king. Third word is courtier. I repeat, third word is courtier. Its meaning is advisor of king. Its meaning is advisor of king. Fourth word is smearing. Smearing means sprinkling. Fifth word is ash. Its meaning is coal powder. Sixth word is rag. Its meaning is a piece of old and torn cloth. I repeat, sixth word is rag. Its meaning is a piece of old and torn cloth. Seventh word is mystic. Its meaning is strange. Seventh word is mystic. Its meaning is strange. Eighth word is ridiculous. Eighth word is ridiculous. Its meaning is funny or very silly. I repeat, its meaning is funny or very silly. So now we shall do our question answers. These question answers are given on page number 42 of your Honeycomb book under the heading Working with the Text. Your first question is, why did the king want no more talk about the Hilsa fish? I repeat, why did the king want no more talk about the Hilsa fish? The answer is, the king wanted no more talk about the Hilsa fish because he was fed up to listen everyone talking about it. I repeat, the king wanted no more talk about the Hilsa fish because he was fed up to listen everyone talking about it. Second question is, what did the king ask Gopal to do to prove that he was clever? I repeat, second question is, what did the king ask Gopal to do to prove that he was clever? The answer is, the king asked Gopal to buy and bring a huge Hilsa to the palace without anyone asking him about it. I repeat, the king asked Gopal to buy and bring a huge Hilsa to the palace without anyone asking him about it. Third question is, what three things did Gopal do before he went to buy the Hilsa fish? I repeat, what three things did Gopal do before he went to buy the Hilsa fish? The answer is, Gopal half shaved his face, smeared ash on his body, and put on rags before he went to buy the Hilsa fish. I repeat the answer. Gopal half shaved his face, smeared ash on his body, and put on rags before he went to buy the Hilsa fish. Fourth question is, how did Gopal get inside the palace to see the king after he had bought the fish? I repeat, how did Gopal get inside the palace to see the king after he had bought the fish? The answer is, when the guards stopped Gopal to go inside the palace, he began to dance and sing loudly. The king heard the noise and asked the guards to bring Gopal before him. I repeat the answer. When the guards stopped Gopal to go inside the palace, he began to dance and sing loudly. The king heard the noise and asked the guards to bring Gopal before him. Fifth one is, explain why no one seemed to be interested in talking about the Hilsa fish which Gopal had bought. I repeat, explain why no one seemed to be interested in talking about the Hilsa fish which Gopal had bought. The answer is, Gopal's outfit and his peculiar look were such that no one was interested in the Hilsa fish that he had bought. I repeat, Gopal's outfit and his peculiar look were such that no one was interested in the Hilsa fish that he had bought. Peculiar means strange. Okay. So now that's it. Now close your notebooks and open your books if you are having your books. If you are not having your books, then open your rough notebook wherever you do your book exercises. So now sixth question is, write true or false against each of the following sentences. The first one is, the king lost his temper easily. It's true. Second one is Gopal was a madman. It's false. He was very clever. Third one is Gopal was a clever man. True. Fourth, Gopal was too poor to afford decent clothes. It's false. The king got angry when he was shown to be wrong. False. Now, working with the language, this is given on page number 42 itself. Notice how in a comic book, there are no speech marks when characters talk. Instead, what they say is put in a speech bubble. However, if we wish to repeat or report what they say, we must put it into reported speech. Change the following sentences in the story to reported speech. The first one has been done for you. How much did you pay for that, Hilsa? The woman asked the man how much he had paid for that Hilsa. So the second one is, why is your face half shaven? Gopal's wife asked him. The answer is, Gopal's wife asked him why his face was half shaven. Third, I accept the challenge, Your Majesty, Gopal told the king. The answer is, Gopal told the king that he accepted his challenge. Fourth, I want to see the king, Gopal told the guards. Answer is, Gopal told the guards that he wanted to see the king. Fifth, bring the man to me at once. The king ordered the guard. Answer, the king ordered the guard to bring the man to him at once. Now, this is your second exercise given on page number 42. Find out the meaning of the following words by looking them up in the dictionary. Then use them in sentences of your own. These are the words challenge, mystic, comical, courtier, smearing. So, the answers are like first, challenge. Its meaning is ask to contest or dare. The sentence is, the boss challenged Rahul to finish his work before the time. Second word is mystic. Its meaning is believing in spiritual power, or you can say strange also. So the sentence is, some people do believe in the mystic forces. Third word is comical. Its meaning is funny. The sentence is, I liked the comical act of the Joker the most. Fourth word is courtier. Its meaning is officials of the king's court or advisors of the king. The sentence is, Birbal was one of the clever courtiers present in Akbar's court. Fifth word is smearing. Smearing means to apply coat or mark, or you can say sprinkling also. Its sentence is, he smears his face with ashes. Now this is your last exercise given on page number 47. Complete the following word letter with the help of the clues given below. This word letter is given in your book on page number 47. You have to complete it using the clues. So, here are the clues. The first clue is, mother will be very dashed if you don't go to school. Second clue is, as soon as he caught dash of the teacher, Mohan started writing. Third, how do you like my dash kitchen garden? Big enough for you, is it? Fourth, my youngest sister is now a dash old. Fifth, standing on the dash, he saw children playing on the road. Sixth, don't make such a dash, nothing will happen. Seventh, don't cross the dash till the green light comes on. So your word letter is, so here this is your letter, cross letter, which you were supposed to fill on the basis of clues given. Okay, so the first clue was mother will be very dash if you don't go to school. Here the answer should be annoyed. But according to the cross letter, your answer should start with C and end with S. So write down here cross, C-R-O-S-S. Second, as soon as he caught dash of the teacher, Mohan started writing. The answer is sight. Write down S-I-G-H-T in second one. Third, how do you like my dash kitchen garden? Big enough for you, is it? So answer is tiny. Write down T-I-N-Y. Fourth, my youngest sister is now a dash old, a year old. So in fourth, write down year, Y-E-A-R. Fifth, standing on the dash, he saw children playing on the road. Standing on the roof. So write down R-O-O-F. R and F are already written, so write down double O. Sixth, don't make such a dash, nothing will happen. Fuzz. So write down F U double S. Seventh, don't cross the dash till the green light comes on. The answer is street. Don't cross the street. So write down street S T R double E T. So this is the end of your exercise and your chapter as well. So your homework is you have to learn lesson number 3, that is Gopal and the Hilsa fish.